Hello dear students, welcome to the second session of chapter 2. Today we are going to discuss text color and link color. Text attribute of body tag is used to change the font color in a browser. Means it is used to change the our information, our content color. How we can change it? With the use of text attribute along with the body . So let's see the example here. Opening body tag, our attribute name that is text, and in the value specify color pink. So like this, along with the body tag, you can use text attribute to change the color of our content in a browser window. Now the next topic is link color. Link color is used to change our hyperlink information, our hyperlink content. By default, we already knows that hyperlink is visible with the blue color and underline. And in the chapter 1, we already discussed how to create hyperlink. So now, to make the hyperlink more attractive, we can set here a link and v link color. And that is useful also, students. By using a link attribute, we can set the color of active links, mean the links that are active now. And by using v link, we can set the colors of visited links. Means students, so many times we are searching something in a Google, and as a result so many links are coming. So which are the links are already visited by you, the color will be changed of a visited link. So when the color is changed, you can see here that that site is already visited by you. So that is the purpose of using a link and v link attribute for a hyperlink. So you just see here one example is available, and this both the attributes we are using along with the body tag. So first opening body tag and a link color is a blue. And then after opening body tag and v link color is a purple. So once the link will be visited by you, then from the blue color, the color will be changed to the purple. So that is the use of a link and v link attribute. Now let's move forward to the next topic. Next topic is a horizontal line. And to draw a horizontal line, we are using HR. Students, HR is a empty tag, means it has no closing tag. HR tag is used to display horizontal line across the page. Means it is used to separate content by breaking it into sections. And it is also called horizontal rule. So basically we can say that HR stands for horizontal rule. And it is useful to divide the browser screen in a different sections. So let's see it with the example. You can see here that now directly we'll see the body section only. So first written, that is our HR tag. And HR tag is used to draw a line. Then after written this line. So then after horizontal line, the first line will be this line. Then after two times HR is written, means with the help of these two horizontal lines will come. Then the content is broken in. Then after again HR, means again horizontal line will come, and then written is a three parts. So here written, this line is broken in a three parts. And how it is broken? That lines are broken with the help of HR text. To understand it well, just see the output. What is the output of this coding? See students, this is our browser screen. You can see here our content. Okay, and where the HR was written, at the place of HR, what is coming? Horizontal lines. So in the first line we written HR only one time, that is why only one horizontal line is coming. Then after second time we written HR two times, that is why two horizontal lines are coming. And at the last again we written HR one time, that is why again one horizontal line is coming. And like this, our content is also divided into the three sections, that is, this line is broken in a three parts, that you can clearly see here. So that is HR tag. HR is the empty tag and it is used to draw a horizontal line across the page. Now let's move forward to the next topic, that is font tag. Students, we already discussed text attribute, and text attribute we used with the body tag. And what was the use of that? It is used to change the color of our content. Now font tag is also just like that, but font tag is not an attribute, it is a tag. And inside font tag we will use some of the attributes to change our text style, text color and text size together. Means by using font tag you can change all the things together. So here font tag has three attributes. Face is used to change font style. Then after color. Color is used to change the color of our text. And size is used to increase or decrease the size of our text. So let's see the example. First line is written with the P tag, paragraph tag. Then after our font tag. And first attribute is a size and size is a 3. Then after next is a color. Color is a red. And then the content is, this is some text. Then closing font tag and closing P tag. So see the students, here the color of text is red and size of text is 3. And here you can see two tags we written together, P, and inside P we use font tag. So students, like this also we can use two tags together in a one line. Then after next example, same is there, color is blue and size is 2. In the third example, see, new attribute is there, that is face attribute, and face means style of our text. And here the style of text is Vardhana and then the color is green. So here we can assume that the first line will come with the red color, second line will come with the blue color and third line will come with the green color. The difference is here, the first line will come with the font size 3, the second line will come with the font size 2, and the third line will be visible with the font style Vardhana. Then after next tag is a base font tag. Here students, base font tag is used to specify the font color, size and style at the beginning of your document. Means you can set the all these things for a whole web page at a time. So base font tag is used to decide the default font and its attribute for the page. See here, the tag name is a base font. Then after attribute face, and our face means style. So face is equals to Arial and size is equals to 16. So now let's discuss the font tag in a detail with an example. So here HTML tag, and then you can see here only body tag is written, no head section. So like this students, you can directly start your content with the body section also. Then after, see, as I told you at the beginning, you can set all the things, means what is the style you want, what is the color you want for the text. So that is why base font tag is written at the beginning of our document. So face is equal to Arial and size is equal to 16. Now you just see, for the all lines we are describing only colors, because style and size we already specified. And to describing colors we are using font tag, not a base font tag. So that is the difference between base font and font. Now font color is red for the first line, then after font color is blue for the next line, and font color is green for the third one line. So let's see the output here. See, we can see the output, the same output came here. The content is same only, but just the text color is different, that first line is red, then blue and then green. So this is the use of font tag and base font tag. Then after, let's move forward to our next topic, and this is the last topic of this chapter, students, and that is special characters. How to include special characters in our HTML document. Students, first see here, some of the examples are given, that is less than sign, ampersand sign, copyright sign. These are the examples of special characters. And we can't use directly these special characters just by typing it through the keyboard. Because you just see students here, less than sign is there. And this less than sign we are using as an angular bracket to write it down our text name. So when you will use less than sign, the browser will be confused that whether it is less than or whether it is opening or closing tag. So angular bracket. So that is why to include special characters, either you have to use mnemonic codes or ASCII value along with the ampersand sign, along with the ampersand prefix. So this is required because the characters like less than and greater than cannot be used directly in HTML document as they can be mixed with the text that I already told you before. Now just see example here. First, before seeing the example, you just see the output. We want basic information written with the less than and greater than sign. So how we are including that, you just see in the example. P tag we are using, P align is equals to center, means our text will display in the center of browser window. Then after C, before using LT, we used here ampersand. So ampersand is the prefix and LT is here the mnemonic code of less than sign. Then after you write it down content, which you want to display, that is basic information. Then after we want to display greater than sign, so again before using greater than you have to use ampersand sign, and then after mnemonic code of greater than, that is GT, and then after closing P. So the above line will print following text on a web page and you can see the output, that is basic information written in a between greater than, less than and greater than sign. So this is the use of special characters. Remember students, one thing that if you want to include special characters, you have to use it ASCII values and mnemonic codes and along with the ampersand prefix. Now, here one mnemonic codes and ASCII values for a special characters, one table is visible. So some of the symbols or the special characters are listed here, their description, their mnemonic code or their ASCII value. See here, ASCII values are available for all the special symbols. So instead of mnemonic code, you can use their ASCII values also to display in a browser. So this is our last topic of this chapter, students. So many topics we discussed here, the topics like first one, the head section, then body section, then after meta text, then after background image, then after background color, then after text color, then after font tag, and then after how to include special characters in our browser. I hope now students the concept are clear in your mind. Thank you students.